So hello viewers, welcome to CXO Talks. I'm Raj Narayan. So today we have an interesting person right in front of us, Sandeep Singh. Before I get to what he does and what he has been doing over the past couple of years, let me just tell you that learning management systems have come a long way. Today they not only sort of help us learn at home at our convenience, they also expand learning across organizations, across geographies, across countries. So sitting right here, I'm in Bangalore. Sandeep is sitting in Noida, Delhi. So we can learn from anywhere in the world. So that is how learning management solutions have come, cloud-based learning management solutions. So what Sandeep does now is he and his colleagues co-founded SPEI, which is a cloud-based learning management solution. They have been in existence, as far as I know, for about 2 years, and they have done wonderfully well for themselves in this past 2 years. So let us go over to Sandeep and welcome him, first of all, on the show. And Sandeep, welcome.
Thank you, Raj, and thank you for having us.
My privilege, my privilege too. So before I start, I'll just add one more sentence. I am using the platform for some stuff. So let me put it on record. So I'm using it and I'm pretty happy with what I've seen. So yeah, Sandeep, so how did you guys sort of think of this as an idea 2 years back, and just your journey quickly?
So definitely. So we were in the edtech space from last 6 years. Okay. So while working with our early customers back in 2015 and 16 to 17, we realized there was a big gap for content creators for a platform which does not only host the content, but give them everything they need. So like people used to have a platform for hosting their content. They used to have a different platform for distribution. They used to have different platform for interacting with their audiences and other tool for marketing and all. Hmm. So idea was to build a platform which offers them all-in-one experience. So right from creating your content, uploading your content, distributing your content, marketing them, and creating sales funnel, everything can be done from a single platform. And that platform should be very easy to use, so that customers can directly, they can log in, they can create their account, they can just drag and drop things, and they can get started with their business. So idea was to create a single platform which can offer everything a content creator needs to market and sell their courses and content.
Yeah. So I also remember hearing or reading somewhere, or maybe I don't know, I can't remember, that your first client or one of your early clients also became your investor. Am I right?
Yes. So it happened, yeah. So in 2018, when we launched this product, one of our early customer, he was so much impressed with the platform that he decided to fund us.
Okay.
And idea was, he was like, he was using some global platforms. So there are platforms like the Teachable and Thinkific. They are like market leaders in our domain. And these are US and Canada based companies.
Yeah.
So, but again, the problem with these platforms are these are not optimized for Indian audiences.
Yes.
So they were like facing a lot of challenges that they tried and tested every platform that is there in the, at least in course space. And then they came to know about us, they tried our platform, and the guy was fed up from last 3 years. He was so happy that, and he knew it right there that these guys are going to make it big.
Okay.
So it was a great opportunity for him and for us as well, that we got funded very early stage, and that capital helped us a lot in acquiring new customers and promoting our product.
Okay, so let me ask you another question now. I mean, you've given us the gist of your journey. So over the last, 12 months, COVID hone ke baad, so has there been any modifications to your the plan that you had initially, or has it sort of been seamless? If I might say, so you were already prepared for a pandemic. Aisa to nahi tha. Pandemic hone ke baad, lot of things changed.
Yes, definitely. So no one like guessed it that it is going to be happen. Yeah. It was never planned.
Correct.
And so we were like, so again, what we were planning to achieve in 2 years, that we achieved in 6 months, okay, thanks to the pandemic, at least in terms of business.
Okay.
And again, so in edtech space, everyone was coming with the online streaming live classes platform. But with SPEI, we launched our live class platform back in last year, in December only. Mm-hmm. So we had that advantage. And when everybody was building a new platform, we already had that platform ready in place. So that helped us a lot in terms of acquiring new customers. The place where we struggled a lot was the scaling our support system.
Mm-hmm.
Because you see, in India, everybody was like almost 80 to 90% audiences or educators. They were coming online for the first time.
Correct.
They didn't have had any idea that how this system is going to work out, how to use this system, because they were quite new to this. So training these audiences and these first time buyers or users was a big challenge. And we didn't have that kind of bandwidth. We were acquiring 100 and 150 or 200 customers every month. We didn't have bandwidth to support them. We didn't have bandwidth to train them. So this is where we struggled a lot, and our team, they had to work 24/7 to onboard these customers, to help them figure out how to run the system. So that was a bit challenge, like hiring more and more guys and providing support to our customers, onboarding them. So that was a big challenge. In terms of product-wise, again, when you scale, you get different kind of challenges. But again, that is acceptable. This is going to happen when you scale your business. Okay. But nothing, we didn't had any problem in terms of figuring out the business model, because that we already tested out in the market and we were there.
So what I'm understanding is that business model may not change in the sense things, the pandemic didn't change too much from a business model perspective.
Yes, absolutely.
Maybe some features got added, or maybe some new ideas got added, but the basic structure was the same.
Yeah. The problem was with the scaling the business.
Yeah, that I got it. So if I were to ask you from your experience, this is again your experience of all the people you have brought onto the platform. What was that one unique challenge that you had to face initially, especially from what you said, people who are educators, people who are coming on the platform, they have never used the platform. Online and digital is not really it's not there in academics, at least. Colleges mein hai, some colleges might have that online learning, like generally it is not there. So what, if in your mind were one or two big problems or big challenges you faced? It didn't hamper you, but challenge kya the?
So challenges, I think from customer point of view, the biggest challenge that customer has, ki mera business chalega or nahi chalega.
Correct.
That is the one.
Correct.
So when they are trying out something new, one is they already have a set of audiences, like kisi ke paas 100 bachche hain, kisi ke paas 50 users hain, 100,000 users hain. But acquiring a new user, they didn't had any idea how to acquire a new customer.
Correct.
So they were not sure whether this is going to be like, whether they will be able to scale it or not. They like, if I talk about offline institute, they do follow this traditional practice, jahan pe they pamphlet batwate hain wo log ya banner lagwate hain.
Correct.
But they had no idea how to do it completely online.
Correct.
So they were not sure how will they acquire new customer.
Correct.
How their content is going to be sold or not.
Mm-hmm.
So this is where they had a lot of problem. Some customers who were in doing something earlier in their journey, they were aware about digital marketing. So a lot of people, they hired digital marketing agencies to do their job, to do the marketing and all, and some didn't. And eventually some failed as well.
Okay.
So that I always tell my customers that it is very important you to like have a platform, and that is very important to have a marketing plan ready with you.
Correct.
Because until you don't have a marketing plan, you are not going to sell your content, and then eventually you will drop out of it.
Correct. So do you do any support for marketing plans currently?
We do train them. We do help them figure out these are the strategies. You need to follow these strategies. But again, we don't do marketing for them.
Okay, great.
And we have all the tools supported in the platform itself. Whatever they want to do, whether they want to do referral marketing, affiliate marketing, organic marketing, all the tools are supported in the system. But again, they need someone at their disposal who can do all those activities.
Yeah. Yeah, that is fair, I think. Because at the end of the day, it is, they know the courseware best, right? So in terms of content creation, what did you see? Were you involved in that process also, or were you just providing the platform and saying aapko jo dalna hai dalo, aapko jo bechna hai becho?
So we don't do content creation.
Okay.
So we do not help in content creation. So again, whatever content you have, because again, those educators, content creators, they know their content best.
Yes.
We have no rights to judge their content. And we are more of technology guy, so we understand technology kaise kaam karta hai, and we don't want it to jump into that domain. So we tell them that you know your content best, we have the platform, you just upload your content and you start selling it. So we don't do help out in any way in content creation.
Okay. So if I were to ask you, Sandeep, again, how would you say, if there are multiple platforms available in the market, I don't even want to name them because I'm sure people know about it.
Yes.
And then since we are speaking about Spay, no, I don't want to bring in the other names here. So let us keep that to that point. So from your point of view, because aap logon ne, 6 saal se you are in the industry, 2 saal se abhi kar rahe ho, So what would you say are your, if I were to ask you, three USPs? If there are more, please share, but then at least three things which you believe you have done differently from the rest of the market.
So first point would be, we are an all-in-one platform, that I would like to say, all-in-one. Everything that you require to run your course platform or LMS platform is there to help you out in all the domains. Yeah. So that is one of our biggest USP. Second is content security. So in India, content security is again still a very big challenge for content creators. So they don't want their content to get pirated.
Correct.
So SPAE is there to secure their content by all the way. So like we have multi-layer security, different security aspect to secure the content of content creators. Then we have an excellent support system, because we believe that, again, in India, the market is still in nascent stage. 80 to 90% educators who are coming online, they are coming for the first time. So training these content creators and helping them figure out how to use the platform, how to get best value out of the system, it is very important for their own success. So at SPAE, we believe that training is and supporting our customers is very important. So that's why we offer it as a core offering of the system.
Yeah.
So support offered by SPAE, the security of the platform, and the all-in-one system. These are the key USP of our system.
Okay, great. So I mean, one of the first point aapne jo bola tha, I mean the first aspect of the, I mean, you said the three USPs, right? The first aspect. So one of the things I found, again, this is my personal experience. Viewers, please bear with me. Was that, I mean, SPAE also gives me the option of creating a sort of a mini website.
Yes.
So you want to speak about that, because that I found slightly unique.
So again, that is part of white labeling. Huh. So what we do, we allow you to create or your own kind of landing pages and website from the platform itself. It's very easy to use drag and drop tool, where you can create your own landing pages. You can have banners, you can have different sections. All the elements are already there into the platform. You just need to drag it and create your own website. Along with this website, you can also launch your own white label mobile apps.
Yeah.
This is something also very unique compared to the our global competition. No one offers this white label mobile app. We are the only company in this space which is offering the web platform, website, white label, and white label mobile app both.
Yes. So, I mean, if I were to explain that for my viewers, what I would say is, so if I, as a person, if I have courses to offer under rajnarayan.com,
yes.
So when I go to SPAE, it is not SPAE which is coming up. It is actually rajnarayan.com.
Similarly, a mobile app will also be created by your name in Google Play Store and Apple Store.
It will have my face or my logo, whatever I want to have there, it will be there. So SPAE goes into the background. So that is one key element that I found very refreshing and very energizing as far as I'm a content creator. So
just
so that my viewers understand that. Okay. Now coming to where you have reached from where you started. Do you want to give me some numbers as to where you have gotten now compared to Definitely. What it was? Yes.
So we started launch this product in 2018. In 2000, early 19, we got a few customers, early customers. Today, we are having 1,000 plus paid customers on this pay platform. At the end of last year, 2019, we were having 200 plus customers. And in the last 8 to 9 months, we got around 800 more customers. So today we are at 1,000 plus customer, paid customer who are using this pay platform. And the most important figure that I would like to quote, that we have helped our customers generate more than 200 crores of revenue through core sales in last 2 years. So this is this revenue has been generated by our creators.
Yeah.
So this is a more important number that I find very helpful, satisfying number for me.
Yes.
For us as a company.
Yes, definitely. Because when you are providing a service, B2B service, I think at the end of the day, what your customer is making is what is...
Exactly. What is the value of the... That value. Is the value of the platform.
Yes. So what next, Sandeep? So we are just coming to the last part of the interview. What next? What do you see as a... Let me ask you a generic question. What do you see as a future for this business? Because I'm sure, seeing your success, I'm sure a bunch of other people will also come.
Yes.
Right? Yes.
Every day companies are popping up.
Yeah. So what do you see the future of this business, and what do you see? How do you see this going in the future?
Definitely. So first of all, I think nowadays, at least in India, we have become brand. So SPAE is a go-to platform for any course creator. We are one of the market leaders in India, and the aim is to keep dominating at least Indian space in the future. and then expanding the whole business and taking space to global level. Hmm. Because we have got few customers from different parts of the world. We have customers from US, we have customers from France, and then Australia, Africa, every part of the world. And these customers, like, they are very, very happy with the platform. They have very great feedback. And that suggests us that we have a great potential in the global space. Hmm. So till now, we have been focusing on India. And we are also working on the product, because when you are taking a product global, you need some aspect, like those should be perfectly fit and those should be there.
Correct.
So I think we will be ready in 6 to 12 months, we will be ready for global launch. And again, the whole aim is to dominate the global market in next 5 years.
Okay.
And we are going to that direction.
Yeah, I don't like asking financial questions, but without asking for your turnover, what I would ask you is, what about the next round of funding? Are you open to that?
Yes, we are actively seeking the funding. We are actively talking to a few investors, and probably we'll be closing the round in next 2 to 3 months.
Great. Congratulations for that in advance. So let me say that. And finally, the way you describe yourself on your website and from whatever I've seen, I mean, you are a B2B platform.
Yes.
So individual content creators are what you are looking at. Now, are you looking at also corporate content creators in the sense, let us say I have an organization which has 10 lakh employees or 5 lakh, 5 lakh employees. Unko bhi content ki zarurat padti hai.
Yes.
So is it something which is on the radar? Are you looking at something like this? Or have you already got clients like that?
Yes, we do have clients.
Okay, great.
So platform doesn't limit anyone. Okay. So anyone who has the content and anyone who has a distribution channel, they can use the platform, and it is highly configurable. Whether you want to distribute your content internally within your organization, or you want to sell your content to outside world, both are there. So those different kind of, so there are a lot of features and functionality in the platform that you can turn off, enable or disable. And that way you can control the whole distribution of the platform. So this is the beauty of the platform, that everything can be enabled or disabled the way you want.
Okay.
So yes, we do have corporate customers who are using the platform. There is a company, AgroStar, who is using the product. Then 5paisa Capital, they are using the product. Sensible, again, they are using the product. So these are the corporate customers who are using our product.
Okay, terrific. So finally, in terms of pay, I mean, I'm sure, because see, a product like this, you will require a payment gateway.
Yes.
Right. And so if, for example, if I am running my courses, I mean, I would want the money to come to my bank, not go to your bank, right?
Yes.
I hope that is not happening, right?
It is coming directly. So the payment is
example is le raha hu Sandeep ki abhi aap dekhenge to in many of the services that you have, say a Swiggy or a or even say something like kya hai aapka cab hailing services jo hai apne Uber Ola type ke, wo pehle unke paas jata hai fir apne paas aata hai na. So I just wanted to clarify that part also. I know this, but then I'm just wanting you to clarify that.
Yes.
The money goes into your bank. Whatever money you make goes into your bank.
So again, what we believe ki this whole platform is yours. We are just there to help you technically.
Correct.
You don't own any content. The content is your, users are yours. Everything, all the transactions, all the content that is being created on the platform, that is yours. ISPE is just a technology provider and technology enabler.
Yeah.
So in terms of payment gateway, we let you integrate any payment gateway that you have. We have already integration with all the major payment gateways in India and abroad. So you just need to integrate your own payment gateway, and then all the payments will directly go to your account.
Yes. One final last question in terms of data security, my data security, for example, my customers, let us say mere paas 500 students hain. So does that data get stored on your server, or is there a security? Is there a way that you protect me from any issue on that with that data?
Again, I told you, your data is your data.
Okay.
So we don't have any rights, or we don't have any authority over all any content that is being generated on your platform.
Okay.
So whether it is your user data, your transactions reports, your content, everything is yours. And we do have all the terms of use and policies. Those are already mentioned on the website, that it is your IP. ISPE is never going to use that data, and it is totally your IP, 100% yours.
Terrific. That sounds really good. So I would say thank you very much, Sandeep, for sparing the time and sharing all of this information with me. Like I said, I'm a user.
Thank you very much.
I'm a user, and all the best to you. I hope that you grow and and we see even more innovation coming from your organization. Thanks a lot. Thanks for
being here. Thank you. Nice talking to you, and thank you for having us.
My privilege. So we'll see how you grow. We'll follow you very closely.
Again, you are a customer. You will be getting all this on a weekly basis.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Sandeep.